Hello guys, I'm showing you a new warrior build, and many people have been asking me to make a more defensive build or just a different playstyle. So I'm trying this new build with basically double mace and one hand axe and shield. And what this build is mostly about is I stack plus healing and life leech on weapons. So every 5 seconds I can do a weapon swap and heal with the next attack for over 1k. More of this is explained in my second video to this build, which is a guide again. So here I'm just showing you some clips, how this build works, what you can do with it, and how you can contribute to your team. I mean, first of all, in 1v1 situations, no one has been able to kill me, simply because I'm just out-healing all the damage. Like here against this Mesmer, I'm full HP, the fight has already been going on for some time. And I'm also gonna end the fight with full HP and successfully defend at this point. And I didn't have to use a single cooldown. Like, with this build you don't need major cooldowns. You have the lead for group situations, but the other cooldowns are like 20 seconds maximum. So with this build you don't really rely on anything. And it's very consistent. So here's a kind of group situation. What I didn't mention yet is, with double mace you have a lot of CC and control, so for example you can knock down targets, you can also daze them for 1 second. It's pretty awesome. You can even debuff them, although I don't find that useful. But yeah, here I'm 1v1 against the warrior, who unleashed a burst on me. It's even an offensive warrior, double X, so he's supposed to do a lot of damage, but apparently I'm just out healing all of his damage with my weapon swaps. And another thing that I'm using is I'm using the ultimate trait of tactics called, which makes my shouts heal, and I got 2 shouts for Great Justice and Shake It Off, and with both shouts I heal for around 2 or 3k, which is also pretty nice. Like this warrior, again, I'm healing up against him, and he's actually jumping down here, killing himself, but yeah, I would have ended the fight with full HP otherwise. So, with this build you wanna do weapon swaps as often as you can, which means every 5 seconds if possible, and also use the shouts whenever needed to heal or to buff your damage. Here I'm up against a Mesmer. Was probably going for the boss kill, so I stopped him. Just attacking him. The damage is not that great with this build, but it's not about damage. I mean, it's about slowly killing your targets without being able to be killed yourself. I see this build great for things like defending points or just capturing something and then standing on it and let nobody else cap it. Here I actually want to go for the chieftain to kill him. It's possible, but it's taking a while. I see an elementalist approaching me, so I'm going on him first. I'm also using Eviscerate with Doom and Intelligence. Just with Intelligence for the auto crit, because I need the second sigil for leeching, for the 1k heal after weapon swap. And as you can see here, I got a healing each tick, like 300 or more. This is the regeneration from my runes. It's pretty awesome. Like, it's another 3k heal if it procs. Yeah, here I'm just going on the chieftain. You can't rush him down like you can with a greatsword or a double X build or triple X, but you can just knock him down, heal yourself up, and eventually kill him slowly, especially if someone else is supporting. Here is a group fight, it seems. In groups, this build is awesome as well, because for Great Justice you are buffing the damage of all nearby allies, and you can also CC the opponents for your team. For example, if you have a big damage dealer like an elementalist with you, then you can lock down the targets, CC them, knock them down, while the Elementalist is doing the damage and killing. So here there are two people going on me for a long time, so I drop low eventually, but even against two people I can last for quite a while. And then whenever I get really low, then my shout's up again and I can heal up. Here my heal gets up in 1 second again. Gonna use it and I'm almost full HP again. Like the Mending Heal also heals for more due to the fact that I stacked plus healing. Here I'm 1v1 against a Guardian. There's no chance that a Guardian can ever get me low, but I will kill him eventually. I didn't play this back long, so I'm not really that good with it, but it was, I played it enough to see the potential of it. And I think if I'm playing this back for a long time and become good at it, that it's gonna be really effective, even in structured PvP, like tournaments. Yeah, healing with my shouts. Sometimes I'm also using them just to get the damage boost. The second shout, Shake It Off, it removes one condition, I think. And you should save this for when you really need it, like when you're debuffed with conditions, then you want to use the second shout. A warrior joins me here. Warriors, again, like any class, I can take them with this build without losing much HP. I got a lot of healing, like you see my ticks 300 each second. And whenever I swap weapons, there's a big 1k heal. If I'm dropping, or if I'm spiking in health, I got two shouts that heal me, and also the strong mending. Seems like some players are joining this pack. I'm just healing up now, waiting for possible help from my team. Here they come already. Now we just clean them up. You rarely dive this back. With the Greatsword or Triple X build, you're playing a burst build. It's a completely different playstyle. And I have to admit that playing a Greatsword build or Triple X, you are going to die eventually, or quite a lot against decent players. Especially if you're up against two or three opponents and they realize that you're playing the burst spec. And I think this spec is great in addition to the Greatsword spec. For example, in tournaments, you can just switch between those two specs and surprise your enemies by being super defensive one time and being super offensive the other time. Like, if a team actually focuses me when I'm running this spec, it's really bad for them because they won't kill me easily and my team is able to do what they want. So yeah, that's it. I'm gonna release my second part, which is the guide, a bit later. And thanks for watching.